Hey everybody, in this video I'm going to show you my most expensive pen as well as my most cherished pen, and the two are not the same. So let's move this out of the way. Now, before I show you these pens, I need to reassemble my Lamy Al-star. It's disassembled because I cleaned it. I've been using it for a while, and it's time to take it out of the rotation. So much like baseball, where you rotate pitchers, I rotate my pens, so that I can enjoy all of them. Or I should say most of them. But for now, let's reassemble this Lamy's All-Star. So let's look at the pieces. We've got the cap. The barrel. The grip section, the ink converter, the nib, down here, this little chrome nib, stainless steel, and the feed. Maybe I'll put this on a piece of white paper to make it show up better. The first thing we have to do is take the nib and slide it into position on the feed. Lamy makes this very easy to do. It can only go on one way, and that's all there is to it. Step number two is to put the feed into the grip section. And it will only go on one way. Let's see here. There. You'll know it when you find it. Or you could just remember that if the grip section has flat areas on it, there's only two flat areas, the rest of it is round. So if you position the two flat areas so that they're facing up, that's the position that it's going to be. The nib came off of the feed. then we push that, and it's on. And the next thing we have to do is put the ink converter and attach it to the grip section. There are some small cutouts on the grip section for these little plastic tabs that you see on the diameter of the converter. These little bosses, little ears, go in, they snap in place into the designated slots of the grip section. Just like that. And now, we'll screw the barrel onto the grip section. I really enjoyed having this pen, but it's time to put it away and use something else. And that something else is going to be my most expensive pen. This is a Montblanc Boheme. Some people may say Boheme because it's spelled Boheme, but it's Boheme. My wife gave me this pen as a Father's Day gift a few years ago. And I normally don't get such nice gifts. So this is a very special pen to me. You can see the Montblanc logo. This pen is made out of what they call precious resins. And I imagine it's all machined, turned, and polished. And it's about a $600 pen. It's not something that I would buy for myself because, well, it's quite the luxury. And Mrs. Relaxing ASMR knew that I wouldn't buy it, so she took it upon herself to do it for me. And screw this. And the first thing you notice is that there's not a nib. So how do you write with a pen that doesn't have a nib? Watch closely as I turn the back of this. Now you see it. Now you don't. So turning this part extends the nib. I actually put this pen into service a few days ago, but I took the ink out of it so that I could demonstrate how to ink this pen. Now, this pen does not use an ink converter, so that means it's not as easy to use bottled ink, because this pen uses an ink cartridge. Like that. That's black. And here's the same thing in blue. But what if you want to use something other than that? Such as Doodler's Widowmaker, which is an extremely deep red. You can see the black widow spider with a red hourglass on her belly. And that's what we're going to put into this pen. So how do you get the ink from the bottle into this empty cartridge? That's where this comes in. Now, don't get squeamish, because this is not a hypodermic needle. It has a blunt end on it. You see, I can push it against my finger and it will not penetrate the skin. It's blunt. It's kind of like a little straw. And it's marketed to do pretty much what we're going to do with it right now, which is extract a little ink from the bottle and put it into this cartridge. Now, there's a right way and a wrong way to do this. The wrong way would be to insert the little, I'll call it a needle, but it's really not a needle. Just like this, and push the plunger. If you do that, you're going to make a mess. What you have to do is you have to put the needle all the way into the bottom, and as you push the plunger, retract the needle as you go. If you don't do it this way, you're going to end up with ink all over the place. Trust me, I learned firsthand on that. So let's put a little, extract a little ink into the syringe. And that's more than enough. Remember what I said, all the way to the bottom. Push the plunger gently and slowly back the needle out of the cartridge. Just like that. I'll set the cartridge out of the way so that I don't spill anything. And we'll take the rest of this wonderful Noodler's Widowmaker, put it back into the bottle. And I'll set this aside. Then we'll put the cap back on the bottle. And let's move the bottle out of the way. Okay, here's the filled cartridge, so what do we do with it? Well, we open the back of the pin. See how that just flips open? And the cartridge just slides right up in there. And when you feel it stop, then give it a nice push. And now it is seated and in place. So now with this pin, you grab this end cap and turn the barrel. And you'll see the cartridge get retracted into the barrel, like this. See? There it is. And now it's gone. Then you close the cap. Pretty simple. Sort of sophisticated. Definitely unique. What do you say we write with this just a little bit? I'm going to post it because that's the way I like to use it. And once it's posted, it's a pretty good sized pen. It writes pretty well, especially on this Clairefontaine paper, which is fountain pen friendly. The nib on this pen is a fine. It's kind of hard to write sometimes in these videos because of all the camera gear and stuff that's in the way. It's hard to get just in the right position. Believe it or not, this is very relaxing to me, even if I don't do such a great job, it's still relaxing. See how small we can make the alphabet with this fine nib. That's 26 letters. I would normally write this large. U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Now I hear my dog barking, which is unusual. So I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I'm not sure what the threat was. But he made it go away. He made it go away. It should be away. 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 And the pen is skipping a little bit. I guess it needs, you know, I had the cartridge out. And now the ink that you saw me fill a few minutes ago apparently has not made its way to the feed yet. There it is. There we go. So everything that we wrote, all of this, up until right here, it was using ink from that was already in the feed. Because like I mentioned, I put this pen into service again a little bit ago, and I took the cartridge out so that I could demonstrate how to fill the cartridge. UVWXYZ. Seems to be working fairly good. Okay. So now my dog wants out. So I'll let him out. And when I get back, I'll show you my most cherished pen. So I'll be right back. Okay. Okay, so the Montblanc is my most expensive pen. And the Lamy Al-star is one of my favorite pens. But this little guy right here is my most cherished pen. Let me put it against a white background. It'll show up much better. this Clairefontaine paper. If you notice on the back, you don't see any kind of bleed through. Some good paper. Now, this pen was made by a company named Wherever, W-E-A-R-E-V-E-R, Wherever. I wasn't able to find very much information on this pen. I think it was made in the early 30s, 1930s. It has a gold nib. And this pen does not use a cartridge or a converter. It uses an ink sac, a bladder. And the body being, the barrel being somewhat translucent, you can see that there's not an ink sac inside there anymore. Over time, ink sacs deteriorate and just disappear. They leak, have to be removed. And the way you filled this pen is you would dip this end into the bottle of ink, and you would work this little lever. And you might not be able to see it, or you may, but working this lever makes an arm push against the bladder. So when you go this way, the arm pushes air out of the bladder, and when you release the lever, the pressure is relieved off of the bladder, allowing it to vacuum up ink from the bottle. So doing this 3 or 4 times would give you enough ink to write for a good long while. If you were to look on eBay, and if you were able to find a pen like this, you could probably buy it for $5 or $10. It's not a very well thought of pen. The Wherever Company was started in Camden, New Jersey by a man named David Kahn. Somewhere, I think it was around the time of the First World War. What they did is they produced copies of big-name pens, except they did it very cheaply. Instead of using craftsmen to make these pens, they used a lot of automation. And injection molding. So instead of machined, lathe turned precious resins like the Montblanc, the cap and the barrel on this pen are probably just injection molded cheap plastic. All David Kahn was concerned about was high volume sales. These are the kind of pens that would be sitting out on the drugstore counter These were the Bic of fountain pens. These were very inexpensive. Mass produced. And not worth much of anything. But yet, this is my most cherished pen. And the reason why is that this is the exact pen that my father used to write with when he was a child. And this pen has meant, or it meant enough to him to hang on to this pen his whole life. This pen is now my pen. And if it meant that much to him, it means that much to me. It's not much to look at. And it's probably not much to write with. But let's lay down some ink anyhow. We're just going to dip into some Noodler's Mystery Black. I'm sorry, Montblanc Mystery Black. This is not a dip pen, but the barrel being void of an ink sac forces us to do it this way. Oops, misspelled fountain. And believe it or not, this thing writes like a dream. The nib appears to be rather fine. UVWXYZ. And the feed holds a pretty good bit of ink. I wonder how many words we can write. I mean, just the fact that I am holding this pen, transferring ink to paper with the same pen that my dad did so many years ago is rather cool to me. I really do like this nib. Kind of surprised at how much I've been able to write off just dipping the pen one time. Really writes good. My handwriting is not worthy of how well this pen writes. You're wondering why I'm repeating the same words over and over. This is how you improve your handwriting. This is how you train your hand. So I've put down almost a page of ink guess I'll keep going. I'm going to have to flip the page. Or maybe we'll write a little on this pad. Will it ever run out of ink? Well, I don't know. I think it's starting to right now. Anyhow, so there you have it. I've shown you one of my favorite pens. I've shown you my most expensive pen. And I've shown you my most cherished pen. And we have written with Noodler's Widowmaker. And we've written with Montblanc Mystery Black. Both very fine pens. I mean, very fine inks. I'm very tired. So, forgive me. Some things on some upcoming videos. I'm going to be showing you my Polaroid cameras. And I hope to go out into the field and take some photographs using the Polaroids of the fall foliage. Also, I am planning on reviewing a fountain pen. It'll be a brand new fountain pen. I'll do a very informal review of the pen. And then give it away. If you've been helping me out through Patreon, and are one of my patrons, I'm just going to draw your name from a hat. I'm not going to show your name or anything like that. That's private information, but I'll probably assign a number to your name and then draw a number from the hat. And then I'll contact you, and if you want the pen, I'll send it to you. Sort of a gift. And that's what it is. It's just a gift for helping me out in being a patron on Patreon. Because I appreciate that very much. And I realize everyone cannot be a patron, and that's fine. I'm not asking for everyone to do that. I'm happy that you guys watch my videos. And everyone will get to enjoy that video. I just wanted to do something nice for the patrons. And I'm thinking about doing that on a regular basis. And maybe I'll do more than just pens. I don't know yet. I'm still kind of thinking about stuff like that. So, that's enough of that. You guys are probably asleep by now. I mean, that's what my videos are all about. First and foremost, they're pretty much just for relaxation and sleep. And I hope this video did the trick. So until next time, thanks for watching.